Hi Aquarius, this is Genevieve with Belladonna Moonbeams. How are y'all doing? I'm doing really well. This is the reading for the week of May 3rd through May 9th, 2021. And I personally have had a wonderful weekend because I took a class on becoming an Akashic Records reader. And I am so excited. The Akashic Records is basically the spiritual book of your soul. Through your different incarnations, living in the spirit world, why you came to this world from the spirit world, things like that. And the Akashic Records are controlled by the Lord of the Records, who've never lived on Earth. And they allow you to see the information that the querent needs so that they might get healing. And I've had the great joy of becoming a reader of that. And I'm so excited. Anyway, let's get with your reading. First, we get the Chariot reversed, which I love the Chariot. The Chariot's a really cool card. See, he is driving the Chariot with his mind. This is because he's got a wand in his hand, just like my wand. You don't see me holding any reins. He's doing it with his mind. And he's got all the stars above. So he's got wisdom and knowledge. He's got the moon here. He's got the, it looks like a caduceus, actually. And then a cross. And the cross can mean a lot of things. It's not necessarily a Christian cross. And you got the black and the white, the yin and the yang. There's a castle there. He's got it going on mentally. Because it's reversed, I'm taking that to mean for y'all that you're being befuddled right now. You're trying to do something and you're not looking at it in the right perspective. So you need to back up and look at it differently. Maybe you need to scry on it. Or maybe you just need to ask your spirit guides before you go to bed every night to help you see things from the right perspective. You're starting, this is a Three of Pentacles. So this is about some a merchant or someone that's moving forward in working with their hands. And people are starting to recognize you for working with your hands and doing this type of work. Now, if you're creative, this could be an artist thing. It could be building something. But it's all about working with your hands and being creative and kind of being a merchant too. In other words, you can sell yourself right now. But next to that, we get the Seven of Swords. The Seven of Swords is one, keep your counsel. So don't tell everybody everything you know. And two, there was someone sneaky in your life. Someone that is not what they seem, that is not on your side, and you need to figure out who they are. So stop and look. You can figure it out. You've probably had that nagging sense already of who they are. But you don't want to acknowledge it because sometimes we're lonely. And sometimes we think it's better to have someone in our life than be alone. And that is not true. A fair weather friend is not worth having. We also get the Queen of Cups. Turn it over. This is a feminine energy that is nurturing. Because it was reversed, though, that maybe it's not quite as nurturing and there's some narcissism going on. But ultimately, this person or this energy has your back. So go ahead and listen to that person and let them nurture you right now. However, don't keep this other person around. That person needs to go. You also get the Eight of Pentacles. Turn it over. And the Eight of Pentacles means you've been working really hard and you're starting to get money for it. You're starting to get gains from it. You're doing the work, you're putting in the time to learn the skill, and it's coming to you. And you also get the star, which is one of my favorite cards. This is about friends and support and the universe having your back. And also it's got water, so there's some emotions going on. But the star is looking at you, and like I said, it's friends, support. Go ahead and revel in that right now. Accept that support. Because I think you, because of this person that's not positive for you, I think that that makes you really sad right now. Now I'm going to pull a couple of cards from Oracle decks. The first card we get is Ancestors, Generations. Does this mean, I don't think that means necessarily that you need to call your grandma, but maybe you need to figure out who your ancestors are. Maybe you do need your Akashic records read, but you check out your ancestors. Look at those soul ties that are pulling you down and figure out where you need to go from here. I also get for you empowerment. So I believe that your ancestors and learning who they are and what they're sending to you, they're your loved ones, that you will become empowered and you will own yourself. And right now it's been like you're a hamster on a wheel. I'm going to pull a card just for relationships. It doesn't have to be like a romantic relationship. It can be friendships, parent-child relationship, something. Intention. Intention is key. And it says to focus on what you really want. So in your relationships this week, be focused. Realize what you want. And if they're no longer serving you, let them go. And if they are serving you, hold them tight and love them. Namaste, y'all. If you want to do a private reading, send me a text to 405-512-9400. And of course, subscribe to my YouTube channel.